God is saying, we're going to perish if we don't walk in this way. You see what I'm saying? We had ways prior to coming over here on slave ships. Our names was Judah, Benjamin, Levi, Gad. We had God-given names.
Right.
Don't let this captivity make you secure. Come on.
This is the book of Luke, chapter 13, verse 3.
No.
I tell you, nay, but except ye repent.
Except ye what?
Except ye repent.
Except ye convert. Except ye change, brother. You got to change your mind.
Ye shall all likewise perish.
You see that? The Bible is redundant. It's saying the same thing.
Right.
We're not coming out here because we're getting paid or something. We're coming out here because we want to wake our people up so we can get the kingdom.
Right.
We are here so we can wake up our elder brothers so we can teach the younger brothers together.
That's right. That's
Psalms
right.
119 and 60.
Bring it
and
I'm
out. I'm going to bring the brother back. Come on back, brother. All right. So, brother, you got to change your mind. Don't make haste. All right? I mean, don't tarry. Come on.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 6.
Where you at? All right, read.
I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandments.
Yes, sir. Yeah, read that. Listen to this, brother. Listen up.
The book of Psalms 119, verse 60.
This is King David. King David speaking. God is speaking through King David. Come on.
I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandments.
He said, I made haste, meaning I hurried up to keep God's commandments. Because if we knew better, we'd do better, brother.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? As long as we're not keeping God's commandments, we're going to continue to be oppressed.
Right.
We're going to continue to struggle out here.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? The drugs is going to keep overtaking us. You see what I'm saying? Our young brothers and sisters, they're going to continue to be getting killed out here.
Right.
Gunned down out here. We just got back from Chicago. Guess what? That place is a wasteland out there.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? That place is terrible. Guess what? If we don't come back to God's law, Savannah gonna be the same way as well.
Right.
Come on.
The book of Psalms 119, verse 60.
Come on.
I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandment.
He said, I delayed not. I didn't delay. He didn't take his time. He didn't stall. He knew I'm supposed to be keeping God's commandments. What happened later on? David became king over all Israel.
Right.
Come on.
The bands of the wicked have robbed me, but I have not.
See, that's what's going on with you. The bands of the wicked have robbed me. Hold these for me. Hold these. You see what I'm saying? The craftiness of our oppressors is robbing our people. The Bible says we are people robbed and spoiled.
Right.
So the bands of the wicked are constraining you. It's got you secure. That's the mind game that they're playing.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? You're asleep, brother. You got to wake up. This Bible was promised to us. The promises of these Bibles are for our people, brother.
Right.
Come on.
The bands of the wicked have robbed me, but I have not forgotten thy law.
But what?
I have not forgotten thy law.
No matter what, brother, in this captivity, we got to walk in God's laws. We got to keep God's commandments. Those are the ways we should be walking. So just like you took off your hat earlier, that's walking in the ways of God, brother. You see what I'm saying? God's laws ain't hard. Check this out. Was that it? If I say, check this out, brother. Listen to this. If I say, thou shalt love thy brother as thyself, right? Is there something wrong with that? Ain't nothing wrong with that, right? What if I say, thou shall not kill? If I tell my brother or sister, thou shall not kill, is there something wrong with that? Ain't nothing wrong with that. So,
what if I say, want for your brother what you want for yourself?
Right. Then is there anything wrong with that?
Nothing.
Okay, so are God's commandments hard?
No,
just like the brother brought out, that's not hard. I want hard for you to take your hat off.
Right.
But guess what? Believe it or not, it's hard for our people
right.
to keep God's commandments. Was that it? Jeremiah 50 and 6.
Bring it out.
Because guess what? We done lost our ways, brother. So now it's time to come back. Throughout this Bible, God referred to us as sheep.
Right.
He used the allegory. He said we like sheep.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Why did he say that? You know anything about a sheep? That's okay. I'm going to teach you something about a sheep today. God referred to his people. The blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, Benjamin, Judah, Gad, he referred to us as sheep. I'm going to teach you something about sheep today.
Right.
Read what you got.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 50, verse 6. My people have been lost sheep.
They have been what?
They have been lost sheep.
Come on.
Their shepherds have caused them to go astray.
A sheep needs a shepherd. A sheep needs a shepherd. You know why? Because sheep have bad depth perception. Sheep don't, they need somebody to guide them because their three-dimensional vision is bad. They don't know whether they walking into a hole or a trap. They have to be guided by somebody.
Right.
So guess what? We out here guiding our people to God's laws.
Right.
That bad depth perception with our people is God's laws.
Right.
My people have been lost sheep. Their shepherds have caused them to go astray.
Now, you know who our shepherds are today? T.D. Jakes.
The white man.
The so-called white man. This man right here. These are our shepherds now. But guess what? We don't have Christ as our shepherd.
Right.
We don't have the real black Messiah as our shepherd no more. Christ wants us to keep his laws.
That's right.
We, that Christianity, all that is garbage. Them people go to church every Sunday, and guess what? They back in their sins.
I always say something to them at Old Savannah City Mission. I see y'all a bunch of fake-ass Christians.
But guess what, brother? How can you tell them that and you're not keeping God's laws yourself?
Right,
it's not with you, brother. Listen, what's your name, brother?
I'm Kareem.
Kareem, it start with you.
I know.
One man got to wake up himself.
No, because they don't want to put you out. You can't eat. And the food donated.
Titus 2, give me Titus 2 and 11. Listen to this, brother. You said what now? What you say? Alright, listen to this. Read what you got. Verse 11.
This is the book of Titus, chapter 2, verse 11. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men.
And say what?
For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men.
Because guess what? When you go, I want you to pay attention, brother. Do you hear what that verse said? It said the grace of God has appeared unto all men. You know what that means? In the church, that means we ain't got to keep God's commandments. That's what they teach. But I'm going to tell you what it means, brother. That you get a small time period to get yourself together, brother.
Right.
This, guess what? It's time, brother. It done been too long. Because guess what? When you pay your light bill, right? Say if your light bill come, you get the mail, right? And then it has a date on it. It says it needs to be paid by this time. Obviously, you got to pay it, right? Okay, let's say you didn't have the funds to pay it, right? Then what happens? You could call Georgia Power. Well, before they shut it off, you could call Georgia Power and you could say, hey, I need to make it
extension.
A what?
Extension.
An extension, right? You can make an extension. That's your grace period.
Right.
That's your grace period. Hey, I need this little bit of time to get myself together so then I can pay my light bill. It's the same thing with God's laws. The grace wasn't put here for us to be like, the hell with God's laws. Eventually, I'm going to convert. No, it's going to be too late by then, brother.
Right.
Guess what? You think when Christ come back and you're not keeping his laws, you think Christ going to be like, well, I give you a little bit of time. It's going to be too late by then, brother. We ask brothers all the time, hey, brother, you want to fly? The brother might say, I ain't got time right now. But guess what? Christ ain't going to have time for you in the kingdom, brother.
Right.
He ain't going to have time, brother. Who?
For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men. Teaching us that denying ungodliness.
That what?
Denying ungodliness.
Because guess what, brother? That's what we got to do. We got to we gotta deny ungodliness, meaning we have to keep God's commandments
right.
And put away sin, brother.
Right.
When you putting away ungodliness, you're keeping God's commandments. Because
right.
Now you're no longer in sin anymore.
Denying ungodliness and worldly lust.
And what?
And worldly lust.
And it's saying worldly lust. So what's a worldly lust? Drugs, right? That's a world. That's things of this world. Alcohol. Different things like that.
Females,
cigarettes, money, lusting after money. Right, those are the things we have. Those are ungodly things that we have to put away.
I ain't being rude, but I got to be somewhere at 12:30.
You got to be somewhere at 12:30? All right, well, listen to this as you, give me about two more minutes. Go up. Was that it?
We should live soberly.
We should do what?
We should live soberly.
We got to live soberly. God, those, guess what? You think it's okay to do drugs, brother? You know why it's not okay? Because we killing each other behind it.
Right.
Because it's witchcraft. We altering the way we think. Because guess what? Our men out here doing crack heroin, and guess what? The kids need food. The kids ain't got no money. They don't have a father in their life. They don't have their grandfather in their life because they strung out on drugs.
Right.
Them drugs, they were never for us. The so-called, our so-called oppressors put drugs in our community.
Right.
You go out to different places like Chicago, they drop them drugs off in our community. Them guns, they drop them guns off in our communities.
Right.
They leave trains right there on the train tracks and leave them open. Bait cars and stuff like that. Just like down there on Montgomery Street, they left that SUV in the car with Dan, what it was, 100 kilos was in the truck, and guess what them young boys did? Went and got it and sold it in the communities. What that's doing for our people? Now we're killing each other. Now the young boys, they said, well, hey, I know where the dope man at, let's go rob him. 9 times out of 10, you're going to have to kill him. That's the mentality of our young men. These drugs ain't doing nothing good for us, brother.
Right.
Because guess what our oppressor do? They focus in on our younger generation.
College kids, I got you.
We should live soberly, righteously, and God.
Righteously. What does righteous mean? Keeping the commandments, applying God's commandments.
And godly in this present world.
And what?
In this present world.
That's talking about today, brother. That's talking about right now, brother. We don't have a lot of time, brother.
Right.
It's time to get ourselves together. Is that it? Give me that and go up to verse... Read verse, verse, 2. The book, start at verse 1.
The book of Titus, chapter 2, verse 1. But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine.
Sound doctrine is God's commandments.
Right.
Sound doctrine is God's commandments.
Right.
Not this right here. Come on.
That the aged men be sober.
That what?
That the aged men be sober.
That our aged men be sober. Come on.
Brave, temperate, sound in faith.
Meaning we have self-control. We have self-control. Don't let them lust overtake you, brother. Don't let the devil win the battle, brother. You got control over your body, brother.
Right.
You the one that got control over that. Don't let nothing in this world stop you from pushing the gospel.
Right.
From waking up your people.
Right.
Our people need men like you, brother. Come on.
But you know what? See that name right here? According to Revelation 1:14 and Daniel, that's my name. My first name, Daniel.
Okay. Well, so you said according to what?
According to the reading. The spirit of Jesus Christ according to Revelation 1:14 and Daniel 10:9.
Because you can read about Christ in the Old Testament as well.
Right.
Okay? This Bible talks about Christ from beginning to the end.
Right.
All
right?
So, brother, Kareem, you see that, brother? So, what should you be doing?
Righteousness.
Yeah, give me that. 1 Corinthians 3:16.
I gotta go. I gotta be away.
Real quick for you though. I know you got to go be somewhere, brother.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 3, verse 16. Know ye.
Start at verse 17.
1 Corinthians, chapter 3, verse 17. If any man defile the temple of God.
You ever heard that verse before? 16, start at verse 16. Listen to this.
Chapter 3, verse 16.
Come on.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God.
It said, know ye not that ye are. Ye are, meaning you, are the temple of God.
Right.
In you, the Most High has a dwelling place. So a temple would be a place of sacredity, a sacred place, okay? Meaning it's a valuable place. It's a place that needs to be kept. A place that needs to be kept. Come on.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
Because the Most High cannot dwell in a temple that is not kept. He cannot dwell in a sacred dwelling place that's not being kept. So even when you read back in the Old Testament, within our physical temples, it had to be kept in a strict order. You couldn't do certain things in a temple. Same with you. You can't do certain things with your temple, your body. Come on.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
Defile. If any man, if you defile your temple, that means you're making it unclean.
Right.
How are you making it unclean? Drugs, being in sin, tattoos, being drunk, anything that's not in accordance with God's laws is defiling your temple. Even unclean food goes with that.
Right.
It's your temple is being defiled. If the Most High is dwelling in a sacred dwelling place, that's your temple, why would you put filth into your body?
Right.
Does that make sense? All right, come on.
For the temple of God is holy.
It's what?
It's holy.
It's sanctified. It's separated. It's separated from everything that's on this plane, brother. Your temple should not be, it should be separated from everything that's on this physical earth.
Right.
This is not like everything else. This is different. Come on.
For the temple of God is holy.
It's what?
It's holy.
Separated.
Which temple ye are?
Which temple what?
Which temple ye are?
You are a sacred dwelling place for the Most High God. The Most High God cannot dwell with you if you're not keeping his commandments.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.